People often get confused on the path on their life about how something like activism and activity in this world, and particularly let's talk about activism and spiritual growth, spirituality, acceptance, surrender, peace, all that stuff, how they harmonize with each other, how they fit together. Somehow our minds always create duality and everything seems to be at odds with each other. It's easy to understand once you have right understanding. Let's say you were bleeding, you had a problem, something happened wrong, and you were bleeding badly. And all the people around you couldn't handle the sight of blood. People came to help, but then they saw the blood and they fainted. They ran away. They said, I'd like to help, but I've never been able to handle blood. Well, you'd be in big trouble. Because if you can't handle something, then you can't deal with it. By definition, that's what it means, I can't handle it. I can't be here present while that's going on because I can't handle it. That means within yourself, it's so freaky to you, it's so difficult for you that you can't deal with the situation. Why? Because you can't deal with yourself in that situation. I've talked to you about this before, but I'm not going to make the whole talk be about this, right? Because it's very important and very few people get it. So can you see that? If what's happening outside, in this case I talked about blood because some people can't handle blood. If what's happening outside causes so much disturbance inside that you can't handle it. It's not that you can't handle what's outside. It's just this stuff out there is atoms. You know that. It's just molecules and atoms are all the same, right? But inside your mind, you have a problem. Therefore, it creates a disturbance inside of you. You get all weird inside. You know what I'm talking about. And you can't handle that. And that's what you mean. I'm asking you to define what you mean. I can't handle that. But I know what it means. It means the situation is unfolding outside. How can the person next to you can handle it just fine? The person next to them likes it. How come? Either the situation is handleable or it's not. What you realize has nothing to do with that. It has to do with the effect that the situation has on your inner state of being. If it creates an inner state of being that is destructive, that is difficult, then you can't handle it. If it creates a situation that's pleasant and nice, you can handle it just fine. You want more of it. So not handling something is an inner state. That's why it's personal to you. What turns you on turns you off. What freaks you out gets him excited. So understand that. That's your starting position. So when we talk about interacting in this world, I don't have to get to specifics about different activist philosophies and things you can get involved in, all of these constant different things that seem wrong. Good, very important things, but basically you have to stop and look. Am I able to handle the thing that I'm going on this campaign about? I'm against this, I'm for this, and so on. Am I able to handle the situation that's taking place? And in almost every single situation, the answer is no. I'm not able to handle it. That's why I have gotten involved in this project. It is something that's uncomfortable to me. There's lots of things going on in our world. People say that to me. There are lots of things going on in our world, aren't there? You turn the TV on, you wish you didn't. There's some really constant, unbelievable, really seriously difficult things that are going on outside, things that could use some help. Guess what? You listen to me. If they bother you, you can't help. That's a tough one, isn't it? If they bother you, then you're just like the person with the blood. Don't go running around screaming about the blood, because you can't help, because you can't handle it. If you can't handle the most terrible things, and I mean the most awful, terrible things that go on in this world, then you're of no use. Because what you're going to do is it's going to disturb you. And because it disturbs you, you can't handle it. And because you can't handle it, you're going to go outside and try to do something that makes it not disturb you. And I'm telling you that is very different than working with the problem. What you will do to make it feel better for you so it doesn't disturb you, so you're more comfortable with it, is almost never, ever the best thing for the situation that's going on outside. Your motive is not even to fix the situation outside. Your motive is to stop it from disturbing you. That's a totally different motive. You have a child. They're 3 years old, or terrible twos, and they're throwing a tantrum in the department store. If it is bothering you, I don't want to see what you're going to do. Because I assure you, it is not going to be the best thing to do for the situation. If you're going to slap the child, if you're going to pull them by their arm out, if you're going to buy them what they want to shut them up because it's embarrassing, not a single one of those things is the optimal thing to do for the situation at hand, is it? And there's only one reason you would do either of those things, because you can't handle the situation. You can't handle it. It's bothering you. Why else would you get rough with the child? Why else would you buy the child what he wants when you know it's you can't reinforce those behavior patterns? It makes a spoiled brat. The reason is because you can't handle it. So I'm telling you, pay attention to me, because you have to extrapolate this to everything, because it's true of everything. I know I can pick a situation like the child where you all agree. You're all shaking your head, yes. Should the mother hit the child? No. Should the mother buy the child what he wants? And just, oh, please, go play. Here it is. No. You know that. You're willing to accept that. Well, what should happen? The starting position is that the parent should be able to handle the fact that children go through different stages and they learn things and they sometimes throw tantrums in the middle of the department store. It's just what it means to be going through your growth. So the starting position is, I can handle that. I was given the responsibility of this child. The child is going through different stages they go through. It's not reflecting on me. It's not embarrassing. It's not, oh my God, how can I ever come back here? It has nothing to do with me. It has to do with the fact that my job is to bring this child up to the best of my ability, and I can't do it if I can't handle it. And I just want you to extrapolate. Give you a couple of examples, the blood with the nurse and the parent with the child. I'm telling you, it's the same thing with the environment. It's the same thing with the terrorist act. It's the same thing with Hitler. It's the same thing with every single thing that can go on this plane. All you're doing is making it bigger, but it makes the same thing. If it reviles you, if it just absolutely you can't handle what you feel like in that situation, you are of no use in solving the problem. All you're going to do is the thing that you think will make it feel better for you. Right? Just whatever you can do. And sometimes that thing is turn away. It's to turn your head away and not deal with it at all. You didn't do that to deal with the situation. You did that as a way to stop it from bothering you. And if you go in there and try to beat everybody up and boom, do whatever you can do to blow the whole thing up, to stop them from doing what they're doing, it's the same thing. This is a difficult topic for people to understand that. I want you to see the one with the parent is easy. I want you to see that everything is exactly the same. Either you're going in there and using force to try to stop the situation from being the way it is without any sensitivity, without any right understanding, without any sense of what is the best that can be done for this situation to raise the situation, not to help me, because it's not personal. Nothing is personal. Nothing is personal. It is not personal that child is throwing that tantrum. Children do it. Okay? And so it's not personal that your husband wants to divorce you. It is not personal that your child died. It is not personal that Hitler did what he did. It is not personal. Nothing's personal. Things are the way they are because there are forces that cause them to be that way. And you're not it. That's the biggest ego problem you'd ever have if you think I'm the cause of this. You're not the cause of anything. If you stop and be a scientist and look at what is going on in front of you at any moment, I don't care what it is, I want you to count how many forces and variables were involved to cause it to be the way it is. And I mean from the beginning of time. That's when my mind finally shut up about this. Nothing is the way it is except for all of the influences that came together to cause it to be that way. Right now, whatever thought you're thinking about what I'm saying, it has nothing to do with me. It has very little to do with what I'm saying. It has to do with mommy and your mommy and your daddy and whatever book you ever read and everything you ever heard before and the fact that your girlfriend just left you so you're open and more receptive, or you just met a new girlfriend and you can't wait to go get back to her. Whatever it is, there's 8 million forces that are going on. How many forces cause the things to be the way they are? Whew. And if you're wise, you step back and you realize, if I say, why is this that way? I have to go back to the beginning of time. I have to go back to the Big Bang. Because every single thing that ever happened is what causes things to be the way they are now. What if the electrical charge of an electron was off by 0.001% from what it is now? Nothing's here the way it is. You are not the doer. You are a participant, but a really small one, right? It's like if it's been going on for 13.8 billion years and it shows up in front of you and you go, boo. Okay, that's one out of 700 billion zillion forces that cause things to be the way they are. It's not proper for you to think that you're doing this stuff. So with the child, you sit there and look and say, there's genetics, there's past experiences, there's this, there's that. There's all kinds of stuff going on. And here I am in that moment. And so you start under all circumstances. This is where activism and spirituality merge. You start with acceptance. Acceptance does not mean you are ignoring the situation. Acceptance is the opposite of ignoring the situation. It is accepting the situation. But what your mind will tell you is, but it's so wrong, I don't want to accept it. That's what it wants to say. Somehow the word acceptance to you means I'm going to leave it the way it is. That's not true. If I accept the fact that this person is bleeding, okay, I accept it. There's blood there. Now let me deal with it. Doesn't mean I left it the way it was. It means my starting position is it's not freaking me out. And because I have accepted the reality of the situation, my child is throwing a tantrum in the middle of, you know, the store. You must accept it. Then deal with it. Because once you've accepted it, you can see clearly. Now you're not in the way. Your disturbance is not disturbing your ability to deal with and see the situation. And I'm telling you, as obvious that seems to you about the child, it is true of absolutely every single thing in the world.
You've been listening to an excerpt from Michael Singer's The Untethered Soul Lecture Series, Volume 10, The Power of Inner Clarity.